So the reason I gave this example is that very often, right, so we think that many of these problems are not interesting, right, or are not important, right. But this question was asked by Erdős, right, a Hungarian mathematician, right. You should Google him and read him and understand his life, what he did. And today, all of computer science is impacted by Erdős's mathematical questions. In one way or the other. Of course, you will not see them inside a router or inside your mobile phone or something. But if you go into the algorithms and the protocols that are there and their analysis, you can be sure that there will be 10% of Erdős's ideas in those mathematical analysis in every device. Then you can imagine the impact of that person's ideas, right, in modern technology. Okay. And the kind of question that he asked doesn't seem to do anything to do with any form of engineering, right? And that is why I am telling you the story of Erdős, that because something looks mathematics doesn't mean that it is useless, right? So here is this question. What integer sets are the degrees of a graph G? Right? Somebody does the following thing, right? Somebody writes 1, 1, 1. Now, give me a graph on three vertices in which every vertex has degree 1. In other words, is this set graphic? The jargon is called graphic, okay? Graphic meaning that I give you a set of degrees and you must tell me whether there is a graph whose n vertices have degrees exactly from this n element set. So now you must give me a three vertex graph in which all the degrees are 1. Right? But obviously, in this case, it is not possible. In the simple example, it is not possible because, right, as you already know, right, the sum of the degrees must be even. In this case, the sum of the degrees is 3, which is odd. Therefore, the immediate answer is no. Right? But what if I make the situation more complicated? I give you another set. Right? Now, can you check? Right? So, one condition which is important is that the sum of degrees must be even. Do you think it is sufficient? Now take a couple of minutes. Give me a degree set where the sum of the degrees is 2 times n minus 1, but you can observe something and tell me that there is no graph with this degree sequence. So let us just understand this. It says that if somebody gives you these n degrees, right, in a set, what you do is you visualize them first of all in non-decreasing order, right? And to check whether this fellow is graphic, you have to check if the n minus 1 element set, right, which consists of, first of all, d1 is thrown out, right? And the first d1 values after removing d1 are reduced by 1 and the rest of them are kept as it is. Fine. If this is graphic, then the original sequence is graphic, and if the original sequence is graphic, we are going to show that this is also graphic. Fine. It's a different thought process. I can do an example, but I will do a proof. The proof takes care of all the examples. So, you have to understand the logical statement. Input consists of a set d1, d2 to dn. You have to decide whether there is a graph or not. Right? To decide if there is a graph, you only have to construct in your algorithm. It will be a recursive algorithm. You take the set. Right? You first sort the degrees in non-decreasing order. Generate a new set. The set will have n minus 1 elements. Throw out d1, right? That's how you get a set. Then the next d1 elements, right? So observe that this d1 and this d1 are one and the same, right? You take the next element, which is 2 all the way up to d1, right? Reduce each of them by 1 and consider the remaining as it is in the set. You ask, is this fellow graphic? So it's a recursive program, right? So many of you must have read Fact. How many of you have seen Factorial Recursive Program? Sure, all of you know. Towers of Hanoi you must have seen. But you see, this is a very interesting non-trivial recursive program. So actually, if you learn recursion, this is a very nice recursive program to learn recursion from. Right? Now you have to check if this guy is graphic. Right? What is a base case? Because recursion keeps reducing the problem size. No, what is a base case? N is equal to 1. Now, when n is equal to 1, what should d1 be for you to give a yes answer? D1 should be equal to 0. Any other value, you will say no. And how many graphs are there? A unique graph, obviously. This is the only graph. Fine? Fine? So, therefore, the recursion is completely specified. The boundary condition is clear. In every recursion call, the input, the argument size is decreasing in size. Right. So, finally, it will come down to a single vertex. When it comes down to a single vertex, you check its degree. If the degree is equal to 1, if the degree is equal to 0, you say yes. If it is not equal to 0, you say no. Right. That is the whole recursive algorithm. So, now I will give you an exercise. Please program this. Right. It will take you not more than 15 minutes to program it. Right. You just have one function which reads the values from the input, puts it into an array, passes that array as an argument to this recursive function, right, and runs. That's all. Fine. All right. Now let's complete a proof of this guy. The base case is done. So, what is the claim that I am going to prove? I am going to prove the forward direction of my claim. Remember, my claim had if and only if, which means that it is a logical statement which says that if something is true, then something is true. Right? If P is true, then Q is true. Because it is if and only if, it shows that if Q is true, then P is also true. So, let us prove one direction. If D1, D2 to Dn is graphic, then I am going to claim that this sequence is also graphic, which means you should be able to give me a graph. Right? From the graph I will construct, right? So I will show you how to construct from this graph a G prime which will have exactly this degree sequence, right? So what is the idea? Look at a vertex V, its degree is the maximum degree in the graph G. So consider G which is there, which is given by the premise, the starting hypothesis, right? That G is a graph with exactly that degree sequence. Fix a vertex V here, the degree of V is D1, which is the maximum degree, right. So, this is N of V. Right. Now, what am I? There are two cases. So, what did I do? Remember that I considered the degrees in increasing order. So, we are doing a logical argument here. Consider the degrees in increasing order, sorry, non-decreasing order, D1 greater than or equal to D2 up to Dn, right. Somebody comes and says, yes, this is a graphic sequence, which means that somebody comes and says that this graph G is available. I want to convince myself that this sequence also has a corresponding graph. What does your intuition say? Intuition says, remove this vertex V. All the neighbors' degrees have become reduced by 1. Right? That part is correct. But now you are going to next jump and claim that all the vertex degrees are from this set D2 minus 1 up to D1. Right? So that step requires a proof. You cannot blindly assume it. We have to write a small proof for that. Fine. How do I write it? By constructing a graph G prime and without any ambiguity. So you will see in my proof that there is no belief that your thought is correct. It will be every statement will be logically supported by a preceding statement. Right? That is the focus of this. Right? So let us run the argument now. So you have this vertex V. These are the neighbors N of V. Right? First observation is that the neighbors N of V have the first case, right, the neighbors N of V have the degrees whose positions are D2 to DD minus 1, not the values. You understand what I am trying to say? Right? So you look at D1, D2 to DN, right? Now you look at the vertices of degrees, its neighbors, right? Some of the vertices. So now if you look at D2 up to D1, right? Some of these vertices may correspond to N of V. Maybe this corresponds to a vertex in the neighborhood of V. Maybe this corresponds to a vertex in the neighborhood of V. Maybe this does not, right? Or this one does not, but some of them don't. So let us just see, right? So V is, let us say, an X, right? Now, what I am going to argue is that I am going to be able to identify a vertex W here, right, and a vertex Y here. Right, sorry, I just changed this, Y is outside here. So what am I going to say? I am going to say that I am going to go, right? So idea to complete the logical argument, from G construct H such that the degrees of N of V are in the set D2 to D1, right? In which case our natural idea will be over. I take this H, I look at V, I look at the neighbors of V, their degrees are D2 to DD1. When I remove V, the degrees of neighbors reduces by 1, right? And we have proved our claim. So, provided I get the H, what is a crucial property I want? If you show me a graph whose degrees are exactly D1, D2 to Dn, right, I am going to take a vertex of maximum degree, right, and I am going to ask, is this vertex of maximum degree, are all its neighbors having degrees D2 to DD1? See, if there is a vertex of unique maximum degree, then you are lucky, the argument is completed. But if you have 20 vertices of maximum degree, right, then picking any vertex of maximum degree will not help you complete the argument. What is the argument? The argument is that there is a graph G prime whose degrees come from this set. You must carefully choose that particular vertex. Fine. That is the crucial thing. Fine. So let us do that. Is this argument clear? Is the attempt clear? Okay, I see some blank faces. So let me repeat the argument. Let us do the thought experiment, right? I want to argue that if G is a graphic, if this sequence is graphic and G is the corresponding graph, I want to show that this modified sequence is also graphic, which means I must construct a graph G prime. Let us do the thought process. Fine. So what do we do? I go there and I remove, I say, okay, take any vertex of maximum degree, throw it out, right? And reduce the degrees of all its neighbors, right? So I get a new graph, right? And I now claim that this graph has exactly this degree sequence, which is degrees from the set, which is this set. I claim that this is only intuitively correct. To make it logically airtight is to actually start with a graph in which the vertex of maximum degree, right, has degree d1, all its neighbors have degree which are d2 to dd1. Right? Once I come to such a graph, I remove that particular vertex, right, and then the g prime is automatically done. The logical argument is incomplete if I just start with an arbitrary graph and an arbitrary vertex of maximum degree. Fine. So that is what we are going to do. Right. One of its neighbors is not in the set DD1, right? So why, what is the meaning of this? So U is here, right? I have identified a vertex, this W, right? This is a neighbor, right? When you write down the degree sequence D1, DD1 up to DN, W does not occur here, W occurs somewhere at this place, right? This is where the W's degree is, fine. So for the logical argument, it would have been nice if all the neighbors of W had the first D1 degrees, but it turns out that W is outside, right? And U is the vertex of maximum degree. How many vertices are here? D1 vertices are here, right? How many vertices are there in the neighborhood of this guy? This is D1, right? Now this W is not here. Which means that there must be some x here which is not adjacent to U. So that x is somewhere here. Right? This x is somewhere here. Therefore, and this x is not adjacent to this. So what am I going to do? I am going to identify so vertex Z here, and I am going to argue that, sorry, I can do an exchange, right, of the position of W. I am going to argue that I can take X and I can take W. And I can perform an exchange of x and w, and I will get a different graph. So exchange can modify G by the following procedure. Remove the edge UW, okay. Add the edge UX, remove XZ and add WZ. I have to show you that this can have, this can be done, right? So what is my wish? My wish is somehow to ensure that the degree of U, all the edges in the degree of U occur in the first D1 places, then my logical argument will be complete, right? Now it's not happening. Why is it not happening? There is a neighbor of U which is called W, which does not occur in the first D1 places, right? So my argument does not continue. So what do? I say, okay, I only need one graph G. Instead of the graph G, I will construct a different graph called H. What will I do in that graph H? I will ensure that more number of neighbors of U are in the first D1 places, right? How will I ensure that? Here is the procedure. I take this bad vertex UW, W does not occur in the first D1, so I remove it. I bring in an X. I remove the edge from U to W and I add the edge UX. So the degree of U is now taken care of, right? But what happened in the process? W's degree has reduced, right? And X's degree has increased. So what am I going to do? I am going to say that I am going to find a common Z such that I will remove XZ, which means the degree of X which has increased by 1 will now reduce by 1, and the degree of W which is reduced by 1 will now increase by 1, right? And the degree of Z remains unchanged, right? Why should Z exist? So I'll leave this as a second exercise. When we meet at 4 o'clock, I'll give you the complete argument, right? It's not a very hard argument at all. It is just by adding the degrees and arguing something about the role of W and X, right? That will argue that there is such a Z that I can exchange, right? What happens because of the exchange? That I can do this exchange, I will do repeatedly. After doing this a certain number of times, all the neighbors of U will have degrees which are in the first D1 positions, and then you can do the natural thing. Remove X, remove U, and reduce the degrees of all its neighbors. That will be your resulting graph, right? The reverse direction is very trivial. The forward direction is very hard, right? The reverse direction is very easy, right? So let us just, I'll finish with the reverse direction. If somebody tells you that this is graphic, all that I will do is I will take your G prime, I will identify those vertices, right, which have these degrees D2 minus 1 to D1 minus 1, I will add U and make it adjacent to all of them. This immediately proves that this sequence is graphic. So this direction is very easy. To make the forward direction work requires a small observation. So think about it, and we will meet at 4 o'clock and complete this, right? So I think I am out of time. Thank you. I'm stopping. I still have some more time, is it? It's, I thought it was 1 o'clock when the siren. Oh, I see. Okay. Okay, then I'll just continue then. Okay, great. So this step I will still finish only at 4 o'clock, but let me show you many interesting applications of this result and algorithmic programming questions that you can deal with.